How we doing, everybody? Chef Joe Lester, Long Island Cuisine. So tonight, this is very exciting to me. I used to work at the Copacabana, New York City, and, working with George Nabor. He was the executive chef. I was a sous chef at the time, and you had Willie Cruz. He was Puerto Rican, but Willie taught me so much about Latino food, and I just love Latino food, all of it, you know. I didn't really know much about it growing up, you know. Well, the only thing we knew was Taco Bell, right? Anyway, so I'm going to make Latino chicken thighs. So I have fresh cilantro, a small bunch, 1/4 of a red onion, 4 limes, you know, fresh limes. I have my beautiful Bell and Evans chicken thighs, salt, pepper, a little cayenne, and sazon. And I did put like a 1/4 teaspoon of cumin. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the cilantro, right? Okay. It's fresh cilantro. It's a small bunch because you don't want too much cilantro because, you know, it'll kill it, you know. And I have the 4 beautiful fresh limes. Fresh lime juice. Doesn't get better than this. Forget about that, you know, stuff that comes in a jar or... There's nothing better than fresh lime juice, okay? Nothing. And when this dish is done, I'm gonna marinate this overnight. And then tomorrow, I'm gonna make the Latino chicken. And it's like a Latino fried chicken, in a way. But I'm gonna make black beans, like beautiful black beans, and white rice. The only thing I need is avocado and some plantains, which I don't have at this moment. But marinating this overnight is just gonna bring this to another level. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
All right, so now, wash my hands. And remember, when you use chicken, you gotta be very careful how you handle chicken, okay? So right now I'm gonna add a little kosher salt. And the sazon has enough flavoring, but marinating this overnight is gonna be incredible. I'm gonna add a teaspoon of fresh garlic from California, okay? And I'm gonna add just a touch of cayenne pepper. Ooh, that's a lot. All right, that's enough. So what I'm gonna do is take this out of the package, and then I'm gonna marinate this, and I'm gonna marinate this overnight. So we'll be back in a minute. Okay. So now what I'm doing is I'm marinating this overnight, and that's how you get the flavors. You can do this a couple hours before you're gonna make it, but it's not the same. When you do it overnight, the lime juice kind of like tenderizes the chicken thighs, but you can tell like right now the flavors are starting to come together. You know, the lime juice, the sazon, cilantro. And now I'm just gonna cover this with plastic, and then tomorrow I'm gonna finish this off. And we're gonna make a beautiful, beautiful Latino chicken. I love the Latinos. I love them all their cultures and their flavors. And yeah, this is, most Americans don't understand this, but I do. That was because of the Copacabana, you know. All right. I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, so I explained last night my Latino chicken thighs, so I marinated them. I did add about 1 ounce of 100% olive oil, and I just let this sit all night, so the flavors are gonna be incredible. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take like two tablespoons of King Arthur flour, I'm gonna add that to the chicken, mix it up, and the key to this is sauteing it very, very slowly so you render the fat from the skin of the thighs. So this is exciting. Right here I have a fire roasted red pepper. You can't really see it because it's charred. But instead of just taking the pepper and dicing it, I fire roasted this. It's very easy to do it at home. And once it's charred, you put it into a Ziploc, close it, and wait about a half hour when it steams, okay? And then the skin just comes right off. I'm making some nice black beans and white kidney beans. I'm gonna make some nice white rice. I have fresh avocado. I have a nice sweet plantain. And I'm just explaining the ingredients right now. So over here, I got 3 scallions, which I'm gonna, you know, slice thin. I have a small bunch of fresh cilantro, 3 baby carrots, which I'm gonna slice, 1/4 of red onion, and 1 plum tomato. And I'm gonna use 1 package of sazon into the beans, okay? I'm not putting garlic in the beans because I have plenty of garlic in the chicken. So let me begin. Let me clean off that chard off the roast pepper. And I'm just gonna like maybe use 1/4 of that and dice it, okay? So we'll see in a little bit. Okay. So I have my nice saute pan here, so I'm gonna start the beans. I wanna get that out of the way so it cooks a little bit. So I have my onions, I have my scallions, my carrot, my cilantro. I have 1/4 of the fire roasted pepper over here, 1 whole plum tomato, fresh, 2 bay leaves. So I'm just gonna start sauteing this right in here. We're at the right temperature now, all right. And when this is done, it's going to be beautiful. Just spectacular. You know, all the different flavors. Just, you know, it's simple cooking. But, you see how simple the ingredients are? So I just let these sweat out a little bit. And, you know, people make these a million different ways. And I love them all. But the reason why I fire roasted the pepper is it just brings a different flavor to it, you know? And it's just delicious. So now I'm gonna add my tomatoes. Again, I'm not putting garlic in here because the chicken has enough, you know? You don't need garlic and everything. All right, now I put my beautiful fire roasted peppers in there. Oh yeah. It don't get better than this. Yeah, now I smell the flavors. So I have 1/4 chicken stock here. And once this is sauteed, then I'm going to add the beans and the chicken stock. And I'm just going to let that cook for, let it simmer once it comes to a boil for about an hour. And then I'll just adjust the seasoning. Right now I'm going to add a little of this adobo, okay, just a little bit. Come on, not too much. Yeah, see, just a sprinkle. That's all you need. Then I have my sazon. This stuff turns everything yellow. But it gives it a really nice flavor. I like sazon in different cooking, especially Latino. I remember making a roasted pig, the whole pig. It was about 80 pounds on charcoal and wood, and I marinated that for 2 days. You know, with the sazon, the garlic, the scallions, the olive oil, and cumin, and I'll tell you, this pig was the best pig you ever had in your life. Cilantro, lime juice. All right, so this is coming along. Very good. Okay, now I'm going to add my beans. So these are white kidney beans or black beans. All right. Alright, that's good. And I'm going to add my chicken stock. About 1/4. And I'm just going to let this cook. you know, for about an hour. And once I get this done, then I'm going to start on my chicken, okay? So I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, now we're on to the chicken. So again, you know, the tricky part is cooking the fat side down first, okay? Because you want to sear the fat. And then get the skin nice and crispy. Oh yeah, this, look at this. Marinated a whole day. Oh, incredible. Yeah, this is the deal. Now, of course, you know, in the restaurant, you know, you would deep fry this, okay? But I'm not gonna do that. I just saute this. I put like maybe an ounce of olive oil in here. So I'm slowly cooking the skin side down, all right? And I have some flavor here. I'm gonna add this later once the chicken is like 3/4 of the way cooked, okay? I don't wanna put it in now because it'll burn. So I got this on medium heat. And it's gonna take about, I would say about 20 minutes to cook on, you know, the skin side down to get it nice and crisp. So you see, anytime I deal with chicken, I clean everything quickly. I don't ever mess around with chicken. It's delicious to eat, but you can poison people if you don't do it properly. So I got my beans, they're simmering nice. Oh yeah. Now the flavor's coming out. So once I make the rice and the chicken is cooked, I have fresh avocado. I have a sweet plantain here, and I'm just gonna saute these, you know? It's like a sweet banana, but it's delicious. It goes great with this kind of food. The peel is sucking out. Oh yeah. Yeah, we would normally fry these in a fryer later, but I don't have a fryer later, so it's okay. It's no big deal. Yeah, look at that. Nice. It's going to be so nice and sweet. I used to go to this place called Punta Cana. It's in Westbury. And it's Dominican. So they got unbelievable empanadas. Their pinil, their rice and beans, they got gandula beans, avocado, plantain, it's just like, just absolutely delicious. All right, now he's starting to get the flavors out of this. Look at this. Oh, when I show you the color after it's cooked, and also I showed you the fire roasted peppers. And, it, you know, fire roasted peppers I make all the time. I love them. And I just serve them. You know, I put a little garlic in there, olive oil. And I eat them all the time. I mean, you can always use the jar, of course. But there's nothing better than fresh. And now it's April, and I'm chomping at the bit for when Rockham's Farm opens. And they usually open up the first, I would say anywhere from June 28th to July 1st, but, you know, you get there and the first corn is picked. It's, you know, they grow everything there, you know? So, I love going there, and then the tomato season and peaches and, oh yeah. All right, so this is cooking perfectly. Not too high, because I don't want to burn it. And the flour gives it like a coating, right? So it's almost like, you know, like a fried chicken in a way. But the taste, oh man, with the beans and the rice and the plantains and the avocado, forget about it. So you see it slowly cooking. I'm just rendering the skin, you know, getting the fat out. Get that nice and crispy. Yeah, this is perfect. Alright, yeah, so about 20 minutes on this side. Probably do another 15, 20 on the other side because you don't want to serve raw chicken. It's not too good for you. I've seen that happen many times. Well, I didn't know it wasn't cut. Oh, really? Alright. Meanwhile, I just got 20 people sick. week. You know, I'm a chef.
Oh, okay.
Well, how come you serve 100 pieces of raw freaking chicken franchise?
Oh, I wasn't paying attention. Okay. We'll be back.
So, the chicken, approximately about a half hour. You see how crispy that is and caramelized. So now I have the plantains. I just sliced them long ways like this. I'm using the same oil that I cooked the chicken in. And this is going to be absolutely delicious. All that flavor, like chicken fat. What the hell is better than chicken fat? Well, beef fat, pork fat, duck fat, all the fats. Love fat. Oh, you know, it's not that healthy for you, though. I know. But again, they might not have this on the other side. You know what I mean? So yeah, you get all this nice flavor into the plantains. It's absolutely delicious. So the chicken is done. The rice is cooking. The rice is simple. I used Carolina. It's 2 cups of water, like a touch of butter, and 1 cup of rice. Little seasoning. And so all these different flavors with the beans and the rice and the chicken and the plantains. And I'm going to slice some avocado, you know, we'll present the dish. But again, normally you take these, you throw them right in the fat fryer. But again, I don't have a fat fryer. It's all right. It's going to come out perfect. And you can see it, they're going to slightly caramelize, you know. A lot of dishes, like curry dishes, I like to use fried banana. But plantains are great. Okay. Get all that nice goodness. Get all that nice flavor. All right. Perfect. Now we're talking. See? That's what I'm looking for. That nice color. Oof. Yeah, now the sugars are starting to caramelize. That's what you want. Come on. They get a little slimy too, but it's okay. It makes them go down easily. Yeah, oh yeah. And with this kind of dish, I like to use a little green Tabasco. Red Tabasco is not my favorite, to be honest with you, but green Tabasco to me has better flavor. I've just got a little paper towel over here. Okay. Yeah, the beans are starting to smell great. Now, this is going to be such a great dish. Yeah, thank God for the Latinos. Thank God for Willie Cruz, Copacabana, New York City. Chef George Neighbor. George was incredible. He was brilliant. The guy, for the amount of volume we would do in that place, in such a small little kitchen, and as far as organization, George was like, he was phenomenal. Like, just brilliant. Brilliant guy. And a great chef. Highly respected him. Unfortunately, he passed at 50 years old, which is, I couldn't believe it. But, yeah, he was great. But yeah, the Copacabana was just such a cool place, you know. Peter Dorn, Ronnie Holland, John Giuliani, they were my bosses. And they were just, they were great. It was such a cool place to work too, you know. Every week something was different, you know. And then you had Tito Puente, you know, he was from Puerto Rican, and he would come with his band, and the way he played the drums, just magical, magical. Yeah, I missed the Copacabana and the whole kitchen crew and everybody. They were just cool. Okay, so this is a caramelized the way I need it, and I'll see you in a little while. Okay, this is the end. This is the Latino chicken. So we have this beautiful, crispy Latino fried chicken. I told you about the beans. I showed you. I added a touch of cumin while I was cooking the beans. I have my 3 little scoops of white rice, my avocado, and my plantain. So, I mean, the flavors here are absolutely incredible. So I have to taste this. I've been dying for this for 2 days. Oh my God.
Yeah. When you marinate this overnight, the flavors, incredible. Especially with the fresh lime juice. Wow. Sweet plantain. Now, I have to hit the rice and beans. Beans are absolutely delicious. Mm. Oh my God. Incredible. So anyway, this is Long Island cuisine, Latino chicken, and I have to pay my respects to Chef Willie Cruz from Puerto Rico, because he taught me about this, and I just had to reproduce it. But anyway, folks, thank you for watching Long Island Cuisine, and likes, comments, subscribe. But this is easy to do, but the flavors are out of this world. All right, folks, thank you very much.